Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The 7th of December, Monday of the week of Advent 2. The reading, Edmund Steimle, 1907-1988, from Death to Birth. Rollo May has pointed out that, though it is arrogance to say we are masters of our fate, we are saved from the need to be victims of it. We are indeed co-creators of our fate, which is another way of saying that although we can do nothing without God, there are vast areas in our world where he can do nothing without us. And those who want to challenge that might reflect on the biblical demand for repentance, which includes far more than feeling sorry or regretful. It implies a turning around and seizing of the divine opportunity. So Paul, at the end, does not use passive or peaceful images for the response of those who are awake and alive. He draws his imagery from the battlefield. Let us put on the breastplate of faith and hope, and for a helmet the hope of salvation. For faith and love are not passive, but active. They belong to those who are awake, not to those who sleep their lives away. And hope always looks to the future expectantly, not dreading to face it as a man lying in bed in the morning. The prayer, Desiderius Erasmus, 1466-1536. Lord Jesus Christ, who art the light, true, eternal, and unchanging, who didst deign to descend to the prison of this world to dispel the shadows of human ignorance and show us the way to the land of eternal brightness, hear the prayers of my humility, and by thy immense mercy instill into me that divine light which thou hast promised to the world and ordered to be preached to all peoples, that I may know thy way throughout my earthly pilgrimage. Thou art the mirror of life, the torch of all holiness. Thou hast set thyself before me as an example for living. Be thou my joy, the sweetness of my soul. Dwell thou with me and I with thee, with all the world shut out. Be thou my teacher, my master, and may thy teaching be my wisdom. Amen.